So what maybe now? So good morning. So good morning.
Good morning.
Yeah, so this morning I want to proceed with what we were discussing last time. Remember we were discussing concerning what computer hardware. I hope I'm very clear. Am I very clear?
Yes, you're clear.
Yeah, so I think we were discussing concerning computer hardware the last time, and we were able to discuss the memory devices. I think that was the last point in last time, the memory devices. Yeah, but we discussed what the memory devices, and we also discussed what the processing devices. Maybe I can just first remind you on what we covered last time as we proceed today. So this today we are discussing the last bit in the computer hardware. We're going to discuss what we call communication devices. Once you are through, we can discuss now the factors to consider in selecting what a computer hardware. Then we go to the software. Because today was when we have the software, but we have to finalize on what was meaning last time. So let me just remind you on what we discussed last time. We were able to discuss now the processing devices, where we see now that the CPU is what the brain of the computer, and we see now that CPU is able to contain three components. We said it's able to contain what the control unit, and we said at the control unit, it is performs all the operations. It determines the next instruction to be retrieved. Still, the control unit is able to determine. The control unit is able to determine the memory or where information will be stored, either on the main memory or in the secondary memory. Still, we want to discuss what we discuss the next component, the arithmetic logic unit or the ALU. And we said for this one, it is able to perform what two operations. There is what we call arithmetic operations, and there is what we call logic operations. And we said for the operations, they can entail comparison, have sorting together. Then for the arithmetic operation, you said you can have what the you can have addition, you can have subtraction, you can have division and what and multiplication. Then we discuss as well, we said we have what RAM and ROM together. Then we say the RAM now is able to store the information that is frequently accessed by the computer. And we said in the case you are typing and you're not able to your work, that information is reset in the RAM. So in case now the power goes off, that information is what is raw, is lost. Yeah. Then we discuss the ROM, we say. And yes. For the RAM, we say you have to, is it true? Have dynamic and what? The static together. We have dynamic and what and static. And I gave some difference between dynamic and what and static. And like we said, for the static, you do not require refreshing. Is that true? You do not require what refreshing. But for the dynamic, you require what refreshing every time. Is that true?
Yes.
And still, we said for the static, it is expensive as compared to the what to the dynamic.
Yeah,
yeah, these are bits of RAM. Then we were able to discuss the ROM. Is it true? The ROM. The read-only memory, and for this one we said it is non-volatile. The reason we said it is non-volatile, it is able to store the information. Even if the power goes off, the information is retained, and we said it is responsible for storing information, responsible for the booting process. Together, to boot now is to start a computer. Even before I go to the next point, maybe let me ask you in the question now. To explain the procedure of booting up a computer. Can you explain the procedure? How do you start up a computer? Okay. What do you request it? Explain the procedure of home booting or the procedure of switching on a computer. Just give me the procedure, Kaya. Let me hear from you. Yeah. What is the procedure of starting a computer? I want to hear from you. Because you always come across this question in the next exam, it's very examinable. What is the procedure of switching on a computer? Any information came about tester? Yes.
Mwalimu, I can try.
Yeah, just try.
You switch on at the main power supply, pengine on the wall, sindio?
Yeah, yes, that is one point, correct.
Then you switch on the power button on the computer. You click the
which computer now? Is the computer the system unit or the monitor?
The system unit.
Yes, correct. So then
then 60 minutes ikishawaka and then we put kwa monitor, kwa monitor unawasha monitor, si ndio?
Yes, then
then sasa ukishawasha monitor it will take some time, then ikishawaka, then if you have a password you click in the password.
Yeah, that is correct. Yeah, that is actually you are correct now. That is the procedure of what off switching on a computer. The first thing you're supposed to do, you're supposed to switch on the main power supply unit on the wall. Once you switch on that, then you switch on the power button on the system unit. Together from the system unit, then from there, you're supposed to switch on the power button on the monitor. From there, you can follow the commands. Which are these commands now? You can key in with the password. Together. Yeah. Then still that, and we see now the information responsible for that booting is kept in the ROM. And we're able to discuss types of ROM. We discussed, we have what we call the PROM, the programmable read on the memory, whereby it's supposed to be programmed just once. Together, you cannot what? You cannot read it once you program. Then we're able to discuss what we call the erasable programmable read on the memory. And is it for this one? The erasable programmable read on the memory. It can be erased in case now you expose now this ROM in a ultraviolet light for around 40 minutes together. And still we were able to discuss what you call the electrically erasable programmable read on memory. And reason for this one, it can be erased using what electric together. So that is what we discussed concerning the processing devices together. Still we are able to discuss now the what you call the storage devices, whereby we discussed what still the main memory, discussed all that, and we discussed what the secondary storage. And we say now a computer can operate without what? The secondary storage. And we say now for the secondary storage, you can have the hard disk, you can have the disk drive, you can have the hard disk and have the compact disk, you can have the floppy disk. And we say it, most of the computers nowadays, they do not support the floppy what, the floppy disks. So that was the recap or what we covered last time. So this morning I want we proceed with the last bit in what in computer hardware. There is what you call communication devices. I want to discuss now communication devices. And you know now, this is a device or this is a piece of equipment or a hardware that is designed to move information or data from one place to another. What? Another place together. Remember, communication is that conveying of information from one place to another. And now to convey that information, you must require a communication device or that piece of equipment or hardware that is designed now to carry that information from one place to another. Together. So which are these devices that can be used to convey information from one place to another? In a computer, there is what you call the Wi-Fi cards. Together, we have the first one. There is what you call the Wi-Fi cards. Yeah, let me just repeat it for you.
What?
The first one is called the Wi-Fi cards. The Wi-Fi.
Oh,
Wi-Fi cards. Yeah, the Wi-Fi. And Wi-Fi means wireless fidelity. Together, it means yes. What? Wireless what? Fidelity. So now, for you, for example, maybe you're having a laptop, right? Together, you're having a laptop. And now in that laptop now, you're using Wi-Fi. In case now, in your laptop, you do not have that card, there is no way your laptop can connect to the internet. Right? Together. Understood?
Yeah.
Right? Together.
Yes.
Yeah. So once you have the wire set up now, you're able to receive and to send information from one computer to another computer over the net. The next one is what you am I clear now?
Yeah, you're clear. Before so katika usikiki.
I'm saying there is what you call the network interface card or the network connector, the NIC, the second communication device. The NIC. Okay. I hope now it is clear. Is it clear? Yes.
It's clear.
That is okay. So now we have what you call the NIC now. Computers now on a network, they need to be able to communicate with the server or with other computers. And in order for now, for this computer to connect now, a NIC is required. So what is a NIC now? A NIC now is an inbuilt network chip, right together. Is that what?
Oh,
an inbuilt net, yes?
What is it called? A link?
A NIC, I've typed it, we call it a network interface card. Network interface card.
Okay.
And we have said for this one, it is inbuilt. It is inside with the motherboard together. Inside the motherboard now. Now for this NIC now, it allows data to be communicated to and from a network computer. So it is now your computer is in a network, and you have connected them using what? An internet cable together. So they can be able to communicate. Maybe now, let me just show you where a NIC is located together. Can I show you a diagram?
Yes.
Yeah, let me just show you a diagram of the NIC now. Let me just show you. I hope Akin have understood that, the second device after the Wi-Fi. Yeah. Together, you must have what? In your computer, there's what called the internet. The internet port together. So it's connected to the what? The internet port. Let me just show you. Yeah. Are you able to see this diagram now?
So,
if you look at this diagram now, yes,
the internet cable, Sindio.
That is correct. Yeah, that is the internet port now. And now the NIC is connected to the whole port. Is that together? Yeah, it's in the computer now. It is here. It's here now. I hope you understood now.
Yes.
Yeah, that is okay now. So we can proceed now. That was the Wi-Fi card. The next device that requires what we call a router. A router now is a whole communication device. And you know now, the purpose of a router now, it is to communicate with the ISP. That is the purpose of the router. So the router now, who is the ISP? The ISP is the company that provides the internet services. For example, you can have Safaricom, you can have Fiber, you can have Zuku, together. These are all the service providers. Still, the purpose of the router now, it is to move the packet to the intended destination. And I think you have come across a router. Some routers have antennas. Have you ever seen a router? A Kenyan, have you ever seen one? A router. Yeah, let me just show you a router now. We have seen now the purpose of a router now is to communicate with the ISP. Together, for example, maybe you require a network in your household, or maybe you have a business and you require some network. You must be having a router. You must be having what? A router. So the router now receives the signal from the ISP. And after the ISP can be Safaricom, can be Zoom. Together. Still, once the router receives the signal now, it is able to forward a packet to the intended destination. Let me just show you a diagram of a router. Yeah, it is here. I hope you can see that now. This is a router now. Have you ever seen this one now in a Ziba Cafe? Have you seen it?
Yes.
Yeah, so what happens in this one now? It is able, you can connect computers together. So you can have this router now. This router can be connected to a switch together. We have one cable from the router to the switch. Right together. These are the ports here. Can you see the ports here? You're able to see them?
Yes.
Here. Still, if you look at this router here, it is having some antennas. It's having some what? Some antennas. So this router, it can provide some Wi-Fi. Some Wi-Fi. That is what we call the router. And the last device, or the last communication device, is what we call a modem. You have a modem. Okay, have you ever seen a modem? I know you have come across a modem.
Yes.
Yeah. So let me ask, what is a modem according to you?
A modem?
Yeah.
It's a device that can enable one to access the internet.
Yeah, that is correct. So we say a modem is it is a device that is used to convert incoming analog signal together, incoming what digital signal to analog signal together. That is a modem. Yes. A device that is used to convert incoming digital signal to analog signal so that it can be transmitted over ordinary telephone network.
Modulation.
That is the conversion of what? Digital data to analog data. Then demodulation. Yes?
Modulation, demodulator. Modulator, demodulator.
modulation, demodulation, or moderator, demodulator together. Yeah. You can have moderator, demodulate, demodulator, because modulation is a process together. Yeah. Moderator, demodulator. Modulation is a process together. Understood now? Have understood? You have seen the first part is what you call modulation. Modulation. You have seen modulation now. It is the process now of converting that digital data into what? Into analog. Then once you go, the next process is what you call demodulation now. You can convert now the same analog data to back to the digital process. You call what? Demodulate, demodulation. So these are the four main devices. We classify them as what? Communication devices. We have discussed a Wi-Fi card. We have discussed a network interface card. We have discussed a router and a modem. Any question? Because I'm doing that. Any question?
No question.
Yeah. Akinyi, any question?
Akinyi, anasema sauti yake imepotea ziongea.
Yeah, I hope she's supposed to be typing, but we are being together. You'll pay for her, she'll be well together. See, with the recording is possible together. I mean, she proclaimed healing.
Yes.
Yeah. And were you able to view, before I forget, were you able to view the cut?
The cut?
I viewed your cut. I hope you were able to view the marks.
Yeah, the second one I had turned over there. You must be
the first one. The most is now the one.
The first
one was
the first. Maybe you should be the first one.
The most.
Maybe what is out here? Can I cut it? Cut it? Cut it?
I hope now it is clear now. I was having a problem with my network. Is it clear? Is it clear now? Okay, is it clear now? We proceed. Is it clear?
It is clear. It is clear. It is clear.
Yeah. So now, I mark your card together. Maybe we'll discuss that later together because we'll revise on that together. We see where the problem was together, especially the section A together.
Yeah.
So now the next part now, the last part for the computer hardware is now. I want to discuss now the factors that determine the processing power of a computer. I want to discuss the factors that determine the processing power of a computer. So let me ask you, Kenya, which are these factors? Let me see here whether you can know the factors now. Which factors determine the processing power of a computer? Just get some. Let me hear from you. Any suggestion? Which factors? Akinyi, maybe you can type any factor you know, Akinyi. Yeah, which factors determine the processing power of a computer? I want to hear from you. Which factors? Yeah, PE is typing. What about Kea? Which factors can be used to determine the processing power of a computer? Let me see what a PE is typing. We see now the factors.
Maybe the type of computer.
And not really, because now the main factors now, the entire components in the motherboard, the idea that the composite in the motherboard, now we have some components in the motherboard that can be used to determine the processing part of power together, or how data and instructions will be processed. Yeah. Maybe we can have the first one. The first one is what we call the registers. We have the registers. That's the first one. We have what we call the registers. That is what the first one. So when we talk about the register now, the CPU, together, it contains more memory areas. They are called what registers. But together, the purpose of these registers now, they are used to store data and instructions. They are saying contains more memory. It's called what registers, which are used to store data and instructions. So the CPU is processing them. Understood? These are called what the registers. Now, the size of the register determines the amount of data which the computer can work at a time. Together.
Yes.
So we have said that the CPU is going to contain some small memories. So when information on when data is being processed together, they are stored what in the small memories called registers. Then you have said the size of the register determines the amount of data in which the computer can work at a given time together. And you have seen some computers have they are called 2-bit and some are 64-bit. Have you ever seen that? Have you ever seen that you have some computers that are 2-bit and some are 4-bit? You're saying, for example, you're saying some computers have that are 2-bit registers and some have 64. Together.
Yes.
Have you ever seen? And have you ever seen still some CPU specifications have 4 bytes? Maybe, for example, if you go to the specifications of your computer, the properties, you can see this information together concerning the CPU, together, all that. So that is the first component, the register, together. The small memories that are used to do what to store data and instructions while the CPU is processing them. Then the second is the RAM. The second is what? The RAM. Together. So what that is now, for example, in case your RAM is having an 8, in case your RAM is 8 GB, and someone else RAM is 2 GB, that RAM is having 8 GB can process information at a faster rate. So the amount of RAM in a PC has a direct effect on the system speed. That together does what? A direct effect on what? On the system speed. Put together.
Yes.
The more the RAM a PC has, the more program instructions and data can be held in the memory. And still, in case it's having a larger RAM, is what is more fast. Together, is what more fast. That is what we call the RAM. Any question on that? On the RAM. Any question? Can you question? I can see he is typing. Let me see. So after the RAM, the result we have the next, the system clock. We have what we call the system clock. Together, so a computer system clock is able to set the pace. The CPU is using together. This is the what is able to set what the pace. The CPU is what is you is using together. So that system clock it contains what some cycles together, which are measured with what we call the hertz together. Which I mentioned is what called the hertz together. Yeah, this is what we call the system clock together. And you have said its purpose is to set the pace of the CPU by using what you call the hertz together. The faster a PC clock runs, the more instructions is able to execute. So in case your PC's clock is able to run very fast, it can execute more instructions, more data at a faster rate as compared to that PC's. But that PC clock, which is learning at a slower what? At a slower rate. Understood? Let me just show you Maybe I can show you a diagram of a clock. Let me just show you. That is what we call the system clock. Then the last component or the last device is what we call the bus. We have what we call the bus. The computer has what? They have the bus. The bus is now. A bus now, it is a path between the components of a computer. Together, it is a what? It's a path between what? The components of a computer. Data and instructions travel along what? This path, this path. Understood? People understood that. Understood the bus now. The next is what called the bus, and you have seen is the path between what the components of a computer. Is the path between the display chip and the memory, the display chip and what in the BIOS what and the BIOS chip. When you have seen data and instructions, they travel along what this path, together. And we have what we have the data bus, we have the address bus now. For example, the data bus determines how many bits can be transmitted between the CPU and other devices. That is what we call the data bus. It determines how many bits can be transmitted between the CPU and other devices. Then there is what we call the address bus. Now the address bus now sometimes is called what? The memory bus. The reason for that now, it runs only between the CPU and the random access memory together. Its objective or its main work or the main work of the address bus now is to cut the memory addresses together, and that is what you call the address bus. Any question on that? Any question? Maybe I can type it for you. Just a bit for you. Any question on that? On the bus?
No question.
Yeah, that is okay now. So the last factor is what we call the cache memory. I get that the cache memory. And I discussed the cache memory last time. So what is cache memory? Yeah. What is cache memory? I discussed this last time, the cache memory. Memory is. Because it is still another factor that can be used to determine the processing power of a computer. What is a cache memory? A cache memory?
The cache memory?
Yeah. The cache memory.
Cache.
Yeah, the cache memory. I discussed this last time when I was discussing the main memory. What is a cache memory?
Telling myself.
Yeah, so what about a Kenny? Any information, a Kenny? So we see now a cache memory. This is high speed memory. This is a what? A high speed memory that acts as a buffer. This is a what? A high speed memory that acts out as a buffer. And now the cache memory sits in between the CPU and what the main memory. It is, for example, the CPU is here, and you have the main memory is here. It is in between. That is what we are saying. It acts out as a buffer. And now the CPU stores information, not the CPU, the cache memory stores information that is frequently accessed by what? By the CPU. Together. Because now it may take a lot of time to process information from the main memory as compared to time required to fetch information from the what? From the cache memory together. And that is what we call the cache memory. Yeah. Have you understood that? Okay, have you understood that?
Yes. Malimu, can you pardon? The cache memory, that's just okay.
You see now, the cache memory, it is a high-speed memory. It is a what? A high-speed memory that acts as a buffer between the CPU and the main memory. It's a buffer. BUFFER. Yeah, that is a buffer. The reason you say it acts as a buffer, it is in between the CPU and the main memory. So, iko katikati, kuna CPU hapa na kuna main memory together. So, instead of the CPU retrieving information from the main memory, the information is retrieved from the what? From the cache memory. Memory understood. Everyone understood now. Yeah, that is okay now. So the last section in computer hardware now, I want to restate the factors to consider in selecting a computer hardware. The factors consider is the selection of a computer hardware. Which are these factors? And you know that we see the hardware now. These are the physical and tangible components of the compute. The computer.
The computer.
And which are these factors should you consider?
The factors that?
The factors connecting of the computer hardware.
Factors that call.
Yeah, which factors you can consider the cost together? We have the first one, the whole, the core, the cost. What else?
Cost. Power consumption.
Yeah, we can consider that now. Still, we can consider the availability of required personnel, including the cost of training them together. Can consider that the availability of required personnel, including the cost of what of training them together. Remember, you have to train these people on how to use what this computer can be together, maybe it's the printer or what the server together.
Yes.
Still, maybe we can consider now the required operating system, its cost, and what sustainability together. Yeah, still related to what. Together, we can consider that the required operating system, then what is still we can consider the hardware availability together. Remember, you can procure some hardware. For example, in case you buy a Mac laptop, remember this component. In case your Mac laptop goes off at its pressure together, you might get a lot of challenges now in getting a replacement together. So you have to consider what the hardware availability together. In the cost of what acquisition together, the cost of what procuring now or acquiring now what another device together, and still the maintenance now. Some hardware components are very expensive to maintain, and the reason for that now is because now the components are not readily available. Together,
yes,
yeah. So these are some of the factors you have to consider. Yeah, and I'm doing the computer hardware now. I'm doing what computer hardware. Because now I want to go to the computer software now. Any question on the hardware? Any question on the hardware?
No question.
Yeah. So now I want to discuss now computer software, because I believe now, and if you have interacted with the computer software, you know what is a software, you know the types of software in a computer. Let me ask you here, which softwares are in your computer? Let me ask you, which softwares are in your computer? Just give me three softwares.
So softwares are, by the definition,
yeah.
Software is that application that enable the computer to work.
Yeah, so a software now, or a program now, is a set of instructions. Govern the operation of the computer. So let me ask you, which programs, which softwares have been installed in the computer? For example,
VLC.
Yes?
VLC.
Which one? I believe you have installed
the Microsoft Word. Exactly.
Yeah, we have that. Yeah, these are the software. So I want to discuss now the software and the properties together. And you have now, in this topic now, we have the objectives. I want to discuss the software, the characteristics of software together, in the classifications together. So whenever we talk about a software now, these are a set of instructions together that govern the operation of a computer. Of what hardware and what and software together. There is no way a computer can operate, or is no way the hardware can operate without what the software. So a software in detailed step-by-step sequence of instructions together, or what you call that program that guides the computer hardware together.
Yes.
Or you can say these are the set of programs that interface between the hardware and the users of the computer together. They form what an interface. For example, in case I want to interact with the computer hardware, I cannot interact with it directly. I have to interact using what a computer software together. Yeah. That is what you call a computer software. But what are the features of software? One attribute of is a special, it is what? Specialized what? Software. Yeah, that is specialized. The reason we are saying it's specialized now, it can be an aspect of the computer. For example, in the case you compare the OS or the Windows, it controls what? Certain aspects. In the case you compare the Microsoft one now, it is responsible for what? Formatting what? A document. So it is what? Specialized. Understood? The specialization now. Care.
Yes.
Yeah, that is what we call specialization. Every software, it is specialized together. Yet, maybe one thing, certain aspects of the world, of the computer. Still, another attribute of a software is what we call usability. Together, is what we call usability. The extent to which the software can be used with what we is. Together, or the extent to which the software can be used without what? Any problems. Still, an attribute of what of a software. Remember, when we have a software now, it makes the work easier together, or it helps the user to interact more effectively with the computer. Together.
Yes.
Yeah. These are the three features of our software. The classifications of software. There are two major classifications of what? Of there is what we call systems software together. The major classifications, we have two application softwares, and we have what we call the system softwares. So what are application softwares now? When we talk about the application softwares now, these are the programs that help the end user in performing his day-to-day activities. Remember, we are the users of what? Of these software together. Or we are the users of what? Of these computers. So, for example, like Microsoft Word. Like what Microsoft Word, we interact with it day in, day out. So Microsoft Word is what? An application software. It is helping the to perform what? Specific functions in his activities. Understood? Have you understood? Okay, have you understood the application software? That software that enables the user to perform his day-to-day activities.
Yes.
And now, together they are categorized into three. There is what you call the general purpose of it here. The general purpose now that computer can perform a variety of tasks. Yeah.
Excuse me, yes. Sir.
Okay.
Can you pardon? Just say what is divided into three.
Oh, we are saying the application software are categorized into three. The application software. Remember, you said we have two classifications: application software and you have our system software. I have started with the application software.
Yeah.
You have said they are categorized into three. The first classification is what you call the general purpose also software. The general purpose software. Together. Yeah.
Yes.
And you have said for this one now, this is a software or this is a program that can perform a variety of what of tasks. Together.
Yes.
Can perform what? A variety of what of tasks together. So this software can be used, for example, maybe you can use it to format a document together. Like Microsoft Word together, like what Microsoft Word together. Then there is what you call the special purpose softwares, the second classification now. The special purpose softwares.
Software.
Yeah. So let me ask you from the word special, what is the work of this software from the word special now? That definition, the word special. Because you have said for the first one, the general purpose now, they can perform a variety of what of tasks. What about now the special purpose? So whenever you hear the term special purpose now, these are the softwares now that perform single specific what tasks. Together, they perform what single specific tasks. For example, maybe you can have the payload calculation or what stock control. Together, they cannot perform a variety of tasks. They just perform what a single specific task. And I've said, for example, you can have like payload calculation or what managing what the stock. These are special purpose also softwares. Together, then. The last classification is what called a Facebook software. Let me just repeat for you. It's here. Facebook software together. Have it there. this one now, it is written for a single client. For example, maybe I'm the customer. I require software now to help manage maybe my organization, or I require software now that can help manage the transactions that are taking place in my business. That together, that is what you call a Facebook software together. So for this one, it's written for a specific client. Together. But it will help now the client in forming his business, or managing maybe his business. Together. Understood?
Yes.
Yeah. So for example, maybe you own a business and you require certain software together to manage what? Maybe your enterprise or the transactions that are taking place. You require what? A Facebook software. Understood? For example, yes. You can have maybe you can have a payroll management system, a software. You can have a stock management software together to manage what? The stock. Yeah. But for example, maybe you're having maybe it is a supermarket. In the supermarket, we require a software or a program we call a POS. We require what a POS, the point of sale. This is an example of a Facebook software. And for these ones, they are used by what? By large organizations. But now, the implementations of these ones, they are expensive because they have to be developed based on what customer requirements. Here, your friend.
You are currently the only person in this conference.
Yes.
You are currently the only person in this conference.
Yeah, I'm waiting for you. Yeah, can you hear me? Yeah, can you hear me now? Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes, well, I was waiting for you now. Now, I want to be discussing now, or I want to discuss now the characteristics now of application software together, or the features of what? Application software together. Yeah. Yes. Which are the attributes now of this application software now, or the software now that help the end user performing what? His day-to-day activities. One of the characteristics now, or for example, you can have Microsoft Word, is more interactive. It is not more interactive. That is the first one. It's more interactive, easy to design, through in speed, easy to understand, easy to manipulate, and easy to together. So these are the characteristics of what together. Easy to design, is more interactive, it's through in speed, easy to understand, easy to manipulate now. This is easy to manipulate now. You can configure even the same, so the settings together. Even you can navigate with very, very easy. And the last point you have said, easy to use. For example, I don't think nowadays, only sort of using this software, you can just go and just navigate together. Yeah. If you understood that, care. So now, The examples of the application software, these are common. I think that which are these examples? Which examples do you know about the application software scale? Which examples, apart from Microsoft Word? Because for the Word now, it contains several programs. I'm saying the Office contains several programs. So you can have Microsoft Word, you can have Microsoft Excel, you can have Microsoft PowerPoint, we can have the payroll software, we can have the inventory management software, you can have the income tax software, we can have what? Database software. So these are the examples of what? Application software. Yeah. These are the examples of application software. Now, apart from this software, we have other application software programs. I think that we can have what other programs. For example, there is what we call a proprietary software. A proprietary software is here. This is what? This is another what? Another program now. So when we talk about the proprietary software now, this is a software which has what? Or which one part has what? Has a legal property. I think that all, let me just say this. It's a computer software which is legally owned by someone or by a party. Together, yeah. So for you to have this software now, you must be having some license. You must be having some license. Understood, clear? Maybe you have a soon on the property software. You must be having the license together for you to use what this software together. For the party using this software now, they must have what their license together. Yeah. Okay, can you hear me?
Yeah,
then apart from that, now there is what we call the off the shelf software. Apart from that, there is what we call off the shelf software together. The off the shelf software for this one now. For this one is readymade. That together is what is readymade. For this one, what you have to do now, you have to go to the internet. That together, you have to go to the internet. You can download the software together, or you can buy the software. You can do what? You can buy the software together. This is it is off the shelf. It is readily available, or it is readymade. You can just go to the internet and you buy the software. So that now you can use it in your organization together. Very what? Less expensive. Or still, you can even download. You can do what? You can download. That's good.
Or you can download it.
Yeah, you can download it online. And we are through what you call the application software. So we are through the application software. So the second classification of software is what you call the system software. Now what? The second of the classification is the software. System software. And so this is now a set of programs that control the operations in other computer hardware, in a computer. Also, you can see they are the programs that coordinate the activities of the computer hardware in other programs. Everybody understood that care. The program coordinate the activity of the hardware and other programs. There is no way a computer can operate unless it has what? A system software. And a good example of a system software is what? The operating system. For example, your computer must be having either a Windows 7, is it true? It must be having either a Windows 7, a Windows 10, or a what? Windows 8.1. This is what? This is a system software. So, what are the types of what? System softwares. The first one is what you call the first system. But for this one now, this is a software that allows you to operate the hardware. Together. Hardware. There is no way you can interact with the what with the computer hardware unless you have what the operating system together and you have said you can have what Windows 7. So what are the functions now of the operating system? One function of the operating system is what you call job accounting. That is the first function of the operating system. Job accounting. Don't worry about the notes now. I will share them together. Yeah, don't worry about them. There is what you call the job accounting now. So the OS now is able to keep track of time and resources used by various tasks and one and you and users. That is what called the job accounting. It can keep track of time and the resources used by what? By various tasks and what and the you and the users. Together. So there is a way the OS now can track the resources that are being used by a particular user. The same OS now can track the usage of the superwatch job accounting, keeping track of time and resources that are used by what different users. Then the second function is what you call memory management. That is still another function of the operating system, memory management. Altogether, remember, the OS can manage both the primary memory is the work of the OS now in memory management. Now, it is, first of all, it allocates what? It allocates and deallocates with the memory. For example, maybe requires any process. We require any process that requires to use the memory. It is the work of the OS now to give that process the whole the memory. And once that process terminates, it deallocates what? The memory together. Understood, Kaya? Have you understood? Hey, have you understood? It said that in the process, it had access to the memory. And for how long? So you have said the main objective or the main work of the memory management, it allocates the memory to a process when the process requested to do so. And still, it deallocates the memory when the process has needed. That is the work of the ways in what? In memory management. Have you ever understood, Kaya? Any question on that? On memory management? Yeah, any question on the memory management? Then the next is the system software is also the management. Yeah, what? The customer management. So the way now it decides the order in what it is how to access the processor. The process of CPU. And then the way they say how much time will each process be granted? Yeah. The way now if the process or that process will now they are okay processor for the time and what that process. That is still a mark of the what of the operating system. Allocate and allocate to the process. The student came. The student?
Yes.
Then still we can have the device management. Still, this one is the work of the what of the operating system. To locate what the devices. For example, we can have the input devices and we can have what? Output devices. Have you ever seen, for example, in the case we insert a new flash disk, it is allocated a letter. Have you ever seen?
Yes.
That is out of the way to do what? To locate that what? That whatever the value is. So now the OS decides which process gets access to a certain device and for how long. But together, so yeah. It's able to locate the devices in an effective what? An efficient way. And once now the device do not require the memory, so the OS now is able to do what? To deallocate. Remember, it allocated that device, the memory. That is true, it can be okay back and you can take back what the memory. That is what called device management. Then still we have security. We have security. The operating system uses a password. For example, your computer has what an OS. I believe there's a password. The truth is that what is a password. There is no way identity personnel or there is no way an authorized personnel can access information in your computer since there's a password. Is it true? Is it okay? Tukupa moja. Yeah, that is what we call security together. Then there is what we call coordination between other softwares and what and the you and the users. Still, that is the work of the whole of the operating system to coordinate users and another source of it together. So
yes.
The way now it can assign interpreters together. It can assign yes. Compilers, interpreters to other softwares or the users of the computer system. So these are the main functions of the what of the operating system together. But I believe now there's a unit called the ways. You cover that in detail together. There's a unit of the ways. Yeah, you cover that in what? In details. So the next types of softwares in the, because it's it, for the system software, they are going into two. We have operating system, we have digital softwares. Classification of what? System software. You have operating as the first one, and the second is what we call utility software. Utility programs. Now, the purpose of these ones now, the utility software now, they help the operating system in performing its functions what? They help the operating system in performing its operations what? Better. For example, you can have the antivirus. You can have what? An antivirus. An antivirus software is not an application software. An antivirus software is a what? A utility program. But together, it assists the operating system in providing a virus-free environment for the you, for the users. Understood, care? Yeah, understood, the antivirus?
Yes, I've understood.
And you are disappearing, or you are you might be in class and you are preparing some lunch.
No, ni network. Audio yangu iko on, lakini sasa take ni network venye kuna baridi hivi. Network inasumbua sumbua. But
yeah. I get the point. But even as soon as the person is open now, that is the ways now in providing a virus free hot environment together. Mm-hmm. It can have the examples of antivirus. For example, you can have Kaspersky, we can have Bitdefender, we can have what the EC2 30. Yeah. Any question on the antivirus?
So, like, about the antivirus, can also the antivirus be downloaded, Ama? Ama, it will just be stored by...
You can download them. Some are free. Some are free. For example, download them. Look at it too. You can download it. Even if it's defender, you can do what? You can download them.
Okay. Oh, but some of them are free.
Yeah, but some are free. Yeah, some of them are free. But now you have to be very, very careful as well. You are downloading. Some do not provide efficient protection together. Yeah, some are fake. Yeah. So now the next one is what you call the debuggers. The next type of what? The debuggers. What is debug? Yeah, so now the debuggers now, these are the softwares that are used to shake and debug what? Other programs. For example, maybe there's a problem with your software, that is the computer. It is the work of these debuggers now to remove what or to ensure these softwares are working well. They prevent what or they prevent this. So the debuggers can monitor changes in the computer resources. Programs. I'm going to assume that the Onisic programs. Okay, yeah. Question on the Onisic programs. We have said they are used. For example, in case your computer is having a problem, for example, in terms of the network, you can use the Onisic software to detect together the issues that are taking place in the computer or the problems. So together, yeah. Then we can have a backup software. We can have a backup software together. And what is backup now? Backup is to ensure you have a copy of your file somewhere together. So we can have a backup software together. For this one, it is used now to restore back information or data once a drive has crashed. You can have the backup software. You can have the backup software. Yeah. Then the last one is what we call the disk scanner. Can I have what? The disk scanner. Yeah, disk scanner. Let me just a bit for you. Disk scanner. For this is now they're used to detect problems that are taking place in out in the hard disk. For example, maybe your hard disk is having some bad detectors, but it's having some errors. You can scan using what the disk scanner together. And now for this software now in the computer, you don't install them. You don't what? You don't install them together in the computer. Have you ever seen, for example, in case you insert an external hard disk, this is scanned automatically. Have you ever seen that?
Yes.
Yeah, these are called what? The disk scanner together.
Yes.
Then there's what we call the data recovery softwares or utilities. Data recovery, what utilities now? So this was now they are used to restore back the data once a hard disk or once a partition has crashed. For example, maybe information in local disk D crashed and the information got lost. You can use now these utilities now to restore back now or to recover that information which were in what? In that partition. The data recovery what so softwares. Yeah. Then the last disk, the disk for these two organs, the disk. Because remember your disk may be fragmented. So you can use now this software now to manage the unused space on the hard disk. They are called what? The disk fragmenters. Yeah. Any question? Yeah, I'm doing this computer software now. Any question?
No question. No question.
Yeah. So I'm doing the computer software now. That is what we are supposed to cover today. With a noise on the computer hardware, and it is with a noise on what the computer software. Yeah. In case of no question. So how was the class today? How was it today?
The class was okay. Fine. Enjoyable.
So the problem was the network now. The network together.
Yeah.
Yeah. That is okay. So you had a question on your card. There's a question you were asking on your card. Maybe you can ask another question.
So, Malimu, what about the nini? The cut. The question one. Question one, come in the pattern 2 out of 5. Like, you know, question mini. Question mini, the pattern.
Yeah, you know, you see in section A, the answers were almost the same. You see in section A, what I had done, the answers were almost the same. Together, almost the same. Together.
Yeah, the answers were almost the same.
Yeah, they were almost the same. Together. So, you could. So you have to, it was a bit together. Yeah. Because after the system which marked section A. There's a way I had set the system to mark section A. Understood?
Yes.
Yeah, but that is okay. So any question on that? Any question on COVID hardware on the softwares?
No question.
So next time I'll be demonstrating. Next time we'll have like more of a practical class concerning what the computer software together. It will be more practical together. I'll be showing you on how you can scan the hard disk together, how you can detect the errors using what this software together. So in our next class now, it will be more practical together. We'll be implementing what we have covered today. Understood? So I'll be having a diagnostic software. I'll be having a backup software. I'll be having what a disk scanner. So you have to ensure you're available next year together. Yeah. To be more practical together. I'll be having some practicals on using this what utility pro program together. Okay, there's a discussion question. Now I want to work on it.
Okay.
Now let me just post it. I want to work on it.
Okay.
Okay, I have posted the question. I have posted. Just work on it. I have posted the question.
You are currently the only person in this conference.